Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Let us pray. Father, this morning, we bless your holy name and we thank you for the privilege and the honor of being in your presence this morning, to fellowship, to commune, and to receive from you. The word says your sheep knows your voice, the voice of a stranger that will not follow. Therefore, Father, this morning, we ask that you speak to every heart represented on this platform in the name of the Lord Jesus. We ask that you impact us with the light of your word this morning and enlighten every darkness in our life by it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, this morning, as we offer our praises and our prayers unto you, we ask that you accept our presence and let your ears be inclined to our prayers this morning in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you once again for this privilege. Thank you for what you are set to do in our midst on this platform. We give you praise and we bless your name. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah, glory be to God. We are welcoming to God's presence this morning. Let's go before the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, with gladness and joyfulness in our hearts as we lift up our voice and worship and praise him with these songs.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawn. Time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then here. sorrow, worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Thank you.
To God. Let's go over into our general prayers this morning, plus that Jesus will lead us in that.
Let's receive. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Our Lord and our God and our Father, our Heavenly Father, Jehovah is your name. We bless you and we worship you this morning. Father, we thank you for who you are. This morning we come before you, O God, as little children. Let our prayers be acceptable unto you in Jesus' name. Amen. This morning, we'll be praying for our children. We'll be focusing on our children. And if you don't have children, pray for someone else's children, and God will give you your own children. Our first prayer this morning is, Heavenly Father, we praise you for your love and faithfulness in all things. We thank you for your protection and care over our families. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, this morning we praise you, O Lord. We lift up high your name above every name, O God. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. In all things, we thank you, O God. You are faithful in all things, O God. And we say, Father, we thank you for your protection and your care over our families, O God. Lord, your word says that our children are an heritage of the Lord. Father, lo, our children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruits of the womb is your reward, O God. We thank you, O God. We bless you. We worship you. We praise you for your love and your faithfulness in all things, O God. No exception in all things. We thank you, O God. And this morning we say, Father, receive your glory. Thank you in Jesus' name. Now our prayer number two. We said, Father, we ask that you forgive us of our failures in raising our children aright and help us henceforth with strength and wisdom in doing it your way. Again, Father, we ask that you forgive us of our failures in raising our children aright and help us henceforth with strength and wisdom in doing it your way. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, O God. We bless and we worship you again, O God. We ask that, Lord, you forgive us for our failures, O God, in raising our children aright. And we ask that you help us, O Lord, henceforth with strength and wisdom in doing it your way, O God. Lord, your word says that he that covereth his sins shall not prosper, but whose for confesses and forsakes them shall have mercy. Father, this morning we confess our sins to God. We say, Lord, we are sorry for every wrong way that we have raised our children. We ask that, Father, you forgive us, O God. You have mercy on us, O God. And you help us henceforth, O God, to raise our children aright. Help us, give us strength and wisdom in doing it your way, O God. In raising our children your way, O God. Lord, you said you would turn the hearts of the children to the Father and the hearts of the Father to the children. This morning, we plead with you, O God. Father, turn the hearts of our children towards us and turn our hearts towards our children. Help us, O God. Forgive us for our failures in raising our children aright. And help us send forth with strength and wisdom in doing it your way, O God. Help us, O God. Thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now our prayer number three, we say, Father, we pray you will give the children of every parent represented on this platform a heart to know you and return and submit to your will. Again, Father, let us pray. Father, we pray you will give the children of every parent represented on this platform a heart to know you and return and submit to your will in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, we pray this morning to God. Lord, we pray you will give the children of every parent represented on this platform a heart to know you, O God, and return and submit to your will in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, you said, I will give them a heart to know them that I am the Lord, and they will be my people, and I shall be their God, for they shall return to me with their whole heart to God. Oh, Father, let our children return to you with their whole heart to God. Father, we pray you will give the children of every parent represented on this platform a heart to know you and return and submit to your will, O God. Oh, Father, we ask that, Lord, we pray you will give the children of every parent represented on this platform a heart to know you and return and submit to your will, O God. Oh, Father, help us, O God. Be our helper, O God. We pray, O God, thank you, Lord, for you are a good God. Now, our prayer number four, we said, Father, and by the power of the Holy Ghost, we pray for the salvation of every unsaved child, of every parent represented on this platform. Let us pray. We say, Father, and by your power, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray for the salvation of every unsaved child, of every parent represented on this platform. Pray, pray, oh, my Lord and my God, this morning. Father, you said, you will ask for thee also by the blood of thy covenant. I have sent forth thy prisoners out of the pit wherein there is no water. Lord, it is by your hand that you send us out of the pit where there is no water. This morning we pray. We say, Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, we pray for the salvation of every unsaved child, of every parent represented on this platform. Oh, Father, save our children, O God. Lord, bring salvation to our children, O God. Father, heal our children, O God. Turn their hearts towards you, O God. Bring them to you, O God. Let every unsaved child be saved by your power. Oh, my Lord, rise up, O God. Help us, O God. Be the helper of our children, O God. By your Holy Spirit, we pray for the salvation of every unsaved child on this platform. We say, believe on the Lord and thou shalt be saved. Father, and thy house, O God. Father, help our household to be saved, O God. Help our families to be saved. Help our children to be saved, O God. Help us, O God. Lord, salvation comes from you. We thank you in Jesus' name. Now our prayer number five, we said, Father, by the blood of Jesus Christ, we pray that the minds of our children be protected from every evil influence henceforth, and let whatever stronghold of evil upon their minds be broken. Again, pray, pray, pray this morning. Father, Jehovah, our Lord and our God, we ask you in Jesus' name, O God, by the blood of Jesus Christ, we pray that the minds of our children be protected from every evil influence henceforth, and let whatever stronghold of evil upon their minds be broken, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, rise up and help us, O God. You said, how much more shall the blood of Jesus, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spots to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Father, it is by the blood of Jesus that you purge our conscience. Father, by that same blood of Jesus, we pray that the minds of our children be protected, O God, from every evil influence henceforth. And let whatever stronghold of evil upon their minds be broken, O God. Oh, Father, this morning we plead with you, O God, by the blood of Jesus, we pray that the minds of our children be protected from every evil influence henceforth. And let whatever stronghold of evil upon their minds be broken. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Now our prayer number 6 is the Father, by the Holy Ghost, pour your love abroad into the heart of our children, that they would love you with their spirit, soul, and mind in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the Holy Ghost of God, Father, pour your love abroad into the hearts of our children, that they would love you with their spirit, soul, and mind in Jesus' name. Help our children, God. Oh, Lord, pour your love abroad into the hearts of our children, that they, our children of God, oh, they would love you, God, with their spirit and their soul and their mind in Jesus' name, God. Oh, Father, turn the hearts of our children towards you, God. Help them, God. You say you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. Help our children of God to love you, God, Lord, with all their spirit, soul, and mind in Jesus' name, God. Father, by your Holy Spirit, pour your love abroad into the heart of our children, O God. Let the heart of our children be full of your love, O God, that they would love you with their spirit, soul, and mind, O God. Oh, Father, let the love of God be shed abroad in their hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Thank you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now our prayer number 7. We said, Father, according to your word, by this Christ we were healed. Himself carried our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Let every sick or diseased child of any parent represented on this platform be healed forthwith in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Father, according to your word, by his stripes we are healed. Himself carried our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. Lord, our prayer this morning is, let every sick or diseased child of any parent represented on this platform be healed, be healed, be healed, be healed. Forthwith in the name of Jesus Christ, we rebuke every sickness of every child represented on this platform. We say, oh, you sickness and diseases, we rebuke you. Diseases, we rebuke you. Get lost in Jesus' name. We say, Father, according to your own word, by the stripes of Jesus and himself, Jesus Christ carried our infirmities and bore our sickness. Lord, Jesus Christ has borne our sickness already, and for that matter, we cannot be sicker. We say, Lord, this morning, let every sickness or disease child of any parent represented on this platform be healed forthwith, O God. Father, send your healing virtue into every child, every diseased or sick child on this platform. Father, send that power of healing into that child and heal that child forthwith in Jesus' name, O God. Because Jesus Christ has already taken away our sicknesses. He's carried away our infirmities, and by his stripes we are healed. Healing, O Lord, is the bread of the children of God. Thank you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now our prayer number 8. We said, Father, we pray that our children would be filled with your wisdom in making wise choices in the face of peer pressure in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father, we pray that our children will be filled with the wisdom in making wise choices in the face of peer pressure in Jesus' name. Lord, your word says that so, whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do it all unto the glory of God. Help our children that everything they do shall be to the glory of God. That they, oh God, will position in their heart, oh God, to glorify you. Lord, Father, we pray that our children will be filled with your wisdom in making wise choices in their face of peer pressure. In Jesus' name, God. Oh, Lord, give them the strength, the wisdom, the desire. Oh, God, Lord, not to bow to peer pressure. Not to bow, oh God, to peer pressure. But help them, oh God, to be filled with your wisdom in making wise choices in the face of peer pressure. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, place your spirit in each and every child here, oh God, and give them the strong desire. Your word says, you are able to work in us for us to will and to do of your good pleasure. Lord, help our children, O God, to desire and to will to do of your good pleasure. that they will not bow down to peer pressure and sin, but Lord Jesus, help them, O God. Fill them with your wisdom in making wise choices in the face of peer pressure. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the living God. Let's go into our scripture reading for this morning. We are reading from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1, from verse 19 to 28. Sister Lydia will read for us.
Good morning. I'm reading 1 Samuel 1, 19 to 28. Samuel is born to Hannah. Then they arose early in the morning and worshiped before the Lord and returned again to their house in Ramah. And Elkanah had relations with Hannah, his wife, and the Lord remembered her. It came about in due time, after Hannah had conceived, that she gave birth to a son, and she named him Samuel, saying, "Because I have asked him of the Lord." Then the man Elkanah went up with all his household to offer to the Lord the yearly sacrifice and pay his vow. But Hannah did not go up, for she said to her husband, "I will not go up until the child is weaned. Then I will bring him, that he may appear before the Lord and stay there forever." Elkanah, her husband, said to her, "Do what seems best to you. Remain until you have weaned him. Only may the Lord confirm his word." So the woman remained and nursed her son until she weaned him. Now, when she had weaned him, she took him up with her with a three-year-old bull and an ephah of flour and a jug of wine and brought him to the house of the Lord in Shiloh, although the child was young. Then they slaughtered the bull and brought the boy to Eli. She said, "Oh, my Lord, as your soul lives, my Lord, I am the woman who stood beside you praying to the Lord. For this boy I prayed, and the Lord has given me my petition, which I asked of him. So I have also dedicated him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is dedicated to the Lord." And he worshiped the Lord there. Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Thank God for his word, and we thank God for what he's been doing with us and for us on this platform. We started yesterday with on our Kenyan week. Like I said, most of my sons and daughters in the ministry in Kenya will be taking us this week. And we have one with us this morning. She's actually a Nigerian. I don't know what she's looking for in Kenya, but she lives there, works with the UN. She has a ministry of her own, Praying Mothers, and we're going to hear from her today. Let us receive Deaconess Adejumo as she brings us the word of God this morning.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Oof. Okay, go
Thank
ahead.
You so much, sir. I really appreciate you. Is that my mic or
mute? Yours? Yeah, you have echo. You have to mute.
I think you've joined twice. Mute the other, the mute sound the of the other one.
Okay, 1 minute. Okay. 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 I think I'm fine. Okay.
You still have echo.
Oh.
You have to mute it on the computer itself or the system.
Is it okay now?
No, you still have echo. Why join twice? Shut down.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. You should be fine. I remove the other one.
Okay.
Okay, praise the Lord. Sorry about that. My name is Oluwatoyin Adejumo. I want to thank God and his servants. Pastor Adeyinka is my daddy personally. Amen. I met him 2000 in Nairobi, in Kenya. No, in Jos. And the first question he asked me was, "Are you fulfilling your destiny where you are sitting down?" And I could not answer the question. He said, "Are you sure you are doing all that God has called you to do?" And that created a fresh energy in me. And that energy is what God has used to bring me to where I am. I really appreciate you, Daddy, and I thank God especially for you. Amen. I'm proud to be your daughter anytime, anywhere. Amen. So I want to thank God for this privilege. Has been said, God has helped us to start a ministry to gather women together to pray for their children. Now, why is it important? According to that passage that we have read, Anna prayed and God answered. And in verse 27, it says, "For this child I have prayed." And when you look at chapter 3 of the same Samuel, verse 19 to 21, and the Bible says, "And Samuel grew and the Lord was with him, and let none of his word fall to the ground. And all Israel knew that God was with Samuel." Amen. Samuel was a great prophet in Israel. He was the last judge that ruled in Israel. Why? Because he had a praying mother. And Samuel was found faithful. Amen. In his walk with God, he was found faithful. And that is why it is important to mold the character of our children on the altar of prayer. By strength, we shall not prevail. Let me tell you, there is no perfect parent. Amen. But we can be a praying parent. Your children might not want to listen to your wisdom, but they cannot escape your prayers. And that is why it is important to pray for our children. The Bible is still saying that, and God appeared to Samuel as Shiloh by his word. So how do we train our children? By the word of God. The instrument for training is the word of God. There are times, especially when they become teenagers and young adults, you can't be as assertive with them as they were. You need to just now say, okay, this is what the word of God is saying. But with the prayers, backing up your suggestions, backing up your ideas, I'm telling you, it's sure to fly. Amen. God has blessed me with three children, three wonderful children, and what people call teenage crisis. Honestly, I didn't know it because the word of God was saturating their life. They are sleeping. At times I might be sleeping. I wake up with a prompting of the Holy Spirit. I go to their room. I sprinkle the blood. I anoint them. Now that they are all young adults, they normally laugh at me. "Mommy, but you are just so that you kept doing so on it." I said, "Yes, this is what God has used to keep you." Amen. And that is why it is important for us to pray for our children. We should not be tired. We should not relent. The way we take our job serious, we should also take raising our children serious. It is partnering with God. The Bible says it is God that works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. For everything God has called us to do, we cannot accomplish it in the energy of the flesh. We still need to go back to God to ask him for wisdom on how to raise our children. And we all know if you are parents, no two children are alike. So the fact that you use this method for A doesn't mean it's going to work for B. So we need the wisdom of God at every point in time to ask God, how do you want me to raise these children? How do you want me to raise this child? Amen. So that we get specific instruction from God. Amen. And then we give ourselves to it. Parenting is intentional. It's not something we can wish away. We cannot assume somebody else will do it for us. God entrusted those children into your hands. So he wants you to partner with him to be able to raise godly heritage. Amen. Somebody said you need to raise a G-rated children in this X-rated world. And it takes the word of God and prayers. Amen. It takes the word of God and prayers. It's not just dishing instruction. I told you to do it. It's more than that. We have to live exemplary lives ourselves. As we read the word and the word is transforming us, we also carry our family along. They are our first mission field. The Bible says, "You will receive power and be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea and Samaria, and to the uttermost." Your family is your Jerusalem. And that is where we start from. So that is why it is important for us to keep praying for our children, to mold their character, whatever age they are. Maybe they've left home. It's not too late to start praying for them. Amen. It's not too late that wherever they are, God will mold them by his word. God will keep them. God will preserve them by his word. My focus this afternoon is on Samuel. Samuel in 1 chapter 12, verse 23 still said, he said, "Moreover, as for me, far be it from me that I should sin against the Lord in ceasing to pray for you. May that be the commitment of every parent. But I will teach you the good and right way." Amen. Let that be our commitment. That far be it from us that we should not pray for our children, no matter what is going on. Amen. We should keep surrounding them with the coal of fire, burning around them. Amen. Thereby devouring every work of the beast. We know that the world we are living in now is not the same as it was when we were growing up. So it is putting our children before God on the altar of prayer, that the fire of God will keep burning around them, burning every shaft, every habit, every association that does not reflect God, that will not help them to fulfill the purpose and counsel of God for their life, that God by his fire will burn it off in the name of Jesus. And I want to admonish parents, it's not all the time you argue with your children. Go to your room and pray. Amen. There are times when my children will ask me for something. I don't want to say yes, but I don't have a strong reason to say no. So I will just be quiet. Then I go to my room, Holy Ghost, convict them. And he had that, the minister of the Holy Spirit. He convicts and converts. Hallelujah. So the Spirit of God, they begin to come. By the time I'm coming out, they say, oh, Mom, I don't think I should go. I say, thank you, Jesus. The prayer has been answered. So why should I be arguing with them when the Holy Spirit can take over? Amen. So we get away from a lot of stress and going back and forth with them when we know how to table our case before God. So my assignment this morning is to encourage us as parents to find time, to dedicate time. There was a book that helped me raising my children, The Power of a Praying Parent. It has 30 chapters, and I prayed one chapter per day. By the time my children were teenagers, the pages of that book was already in pieces, because I took it religiously. Because each time I read the story of Stormy Omati, I kept connecting with it, and I kept praying those prayers every day, every month. One chapter. There are some chapters I get to that I feel stuck to pray longer on those items. And for every prayer, honestly, by the time I got this job, I didn't have that time again. But I thank God I invested that time when I had the time, because I was a stay-at-home mom for 6 years. And when I look back, the school principal used to call me, you are not around, but how come you, and they were teenagers, how come your children are well behaved? I said, it is prayers. And when they are telling me what they are doing, I say, to God be the glory. This, I always want to remind me, you prayed about this. Our testimony will be like, Anna, for this child, I have prayed. Amen. For this child, I have prayed. So God is a prayer answering God. He's a destiny molding God. He did not give you those children for trouble. He said, I've not given you children for trouble. It's for glory. He said, the seed of the righteous shall be mighty upon the earth. But we need to sow the seed of prayer, that their glorious destiny will blossom. Everything that God has proposed to them, they will not derail from the ways of God in the name of Jesus. They will not be wanderers, but they will be wonders, according to Isaiah chapter 1, verse 8, for me and the children that the Lord has given me, we are for signs and we are for wonders. That will be your testimony and that of your family in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's commit like Samuel, not to fail to lift up our voice to God in prayer for our children. I want to thank you, and I thank our dad in the house for this awesome privilege. Thank you, sir. I think I'm done with my 10 minutes. I don't want to overstay, so you can invite me again. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God. That is wisdom from above. And the Bible says wisdom is profitable to direct. That is wisdom from above. And in his wisdom is life. So receive wisdom this morning as we go into our personal moment with God. Ask God again for wisdom. And so how to go about it. Some of us have kids that are giving us troubles. Now we don't even know what to do. There is always a way out in God. Ask him for wisdom. Ask him to show you the way to go. And as that wisdom lands, you'll be so amazed at the transformation that will come your way. This is the time for our personal moment with God. Let's go before the Lord. In any other area you want to present to the Lord, this is that moment. It's just your moment before the Lord. And say the way you want it. And the God before whom we have gathered is here as attentive to you this morning. Definite releases will come from him as you make your request known unto him. Let's go before the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Father, we thank you and we bless your name. We glorify your name, King of Glory, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says children are the heritage of the Lord, not trouble from the Lord. Heritage, the heritage of the Lord. He said, happy is the man that his quiver is full of them. You will not weep over your children anymore, in the name of Jesus. Whatever be that conflict, I commanded it uprooted from his root today, in the name of Jesus. But then, let wisdom prevail, the wisdom of God. He said, raise up your child in the way he shall go. When he grows up, he will not depart from it. The ways of the Lord. The ways of the Lord are always higher than the ways of men. The strategy most of you have been using is going to read books of the ways of men. It's always failing. It's always crashing. The ways of the Lord are higher. He says, as the heaven is far above the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways. Receive wisdom this morning in the name of Jesus. And there's someone there. You're hearing us talk about children, children, children. And you say, God, well, I thank you. I'm okay. But you don't have. I hear in my spirit today your case is settled. The one who brought Samuel, when it was as though the case was closed, the woman being subjected to ridicule and mockery, is the same one before whom you are this morning. And he's blessing you with yours in the name of Jesus. He said, because I asked him of the Lord, that's what he said. Yours is being delivered to you again today in the name of Jesus. Don't count age with God. It's irrelevant. Sarah took in at 99 or 89. I think she was 90. So don't count age. I'm telling you by the Spirit of the Lord, yours is being delivered today in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. Thank you because today will mark the beginning of great joy and celebration with our children. In the name of Jesus, blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. Remember, this program runs Monday through Fridays. We'll be back on this platform tomorrow by 5 a.m. Mountain Time because we are based here in Denver, Colorado. And I know that as you gather before the Lord, as we gather before the Lord, droplets of God's grace and blessings from above comes upon us. It comes and descends and deal, bringing refreshing. This is a program you cannot afford to miss. Whatever wants you to be missing it, maybe for one or two, no, fight it. Because there are droplets of blessings from the presence of the Lord. It's like rain coming down, bringing refreshing, bringing productivity on every side. So tomorrow we'll be back here. And I know God himself, who ordained the path of the just to be brighter and brighter, will shine brighter again in this place, on this platform tomorrow, in the name of Jesus. But today, note this, the peace of the Lord be with you. There were storms on the high sea, and all he said was peace be still. And there was great calmness. Not only great calmness, they arrived at their destination when they had been taken off by the waves. That same order of peace I speak into your life today. He said, when he giveth quietness, who then can make trouble? I speak that peace into your life and your situation this morning. Go with it and see every contrary situation subdued before you. In the name of Jesus, it is well with you. We'll be back together again on this platform tomorrow. Let's share the goodness together today. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Jesus is Lord.